have completed the first term, we have completed our half yearly exam, and hope you have all done it well. Now we are moving on to the second term, and the first lesson that we are going to deal in the second term is respiration in organisms. We are going to see what is respiration, how respiration occurs in our body, etc. Okay, now from lower classes onwards, we have heard that we need energy for doing all the things, right? We need energy to walk, we need energy to work, we need energy even while sleeping. So, how do we get energy? That also you know. We get energy from food, right? Now, in the previous lesson, we learned how food that we eat is being digested and converted into glucose. Now, the energy that we get from the food is by breaking these glucose. Let us see how it happens.
Where do we get energy from? We get energy from the food we eat. Food has energy stored in the form of chemical energy. The food that we eat must be converted into glucose to release energy. This process of converting food into glucose is done by our digestive system, which produces digestive juices that convert complex carbohydrates into glucose. This glucose is then taken by our blood to different cells. Inside the cell, the glucose is broken down to release energy. This process is called cellular respiration. There are two types of cellular respiration, aerobic and anaerobic. Let us first see aerobic respiration. Aerobic means involving air or oxygen. So what is aerobic respiration? Aerobic respiration means the respiration that takes place in the presence of oxygen. So in aerobic respiration, inside the cell, the glucose is broken down in the presence of oxygen to release energy. Do you know how oxygen reaches each of your cells? It is when we breathe. The oxygen that reaches our lungs is carried by the blood to different cells in our body. Our cells use this oxygen to break down glucose to release energy. In this process, carbon dioxide and water are released. The next type of respiration is the anaerobic respiration. It is the respiration that takes place in the absence or lack of oxygen. Have you noticed sports persons getting muscle cramps? Have you noticed when it takes place? Muscle cramps usually occurs when a person is involved in heavy exercise like cycling, running, speed walking, etc. for a long time. Such exercises need a lot of energy, and thus the oxygen in muscle cells will be less. In the absence of oxygen, muscle cells undergo anaerobic respiration and produces energy along with lactic acid. Lactic acid is toxic to our body, and the accumulation of this lactic acid causes muscle cramps. Now, what can we do to relieve from these muscle cramps? We can have a hot water bath or a massage in the affected area. This will help in increasing the blood circulation in that area. More blood means more oxygen. So, in the presence of oxygen, the lactic acid will be broken down into carbon dioxide and water, and the cramp will be released. This is yeast in sugar solution. Do you know how yeast cells get energy? They get energy by anaerobic respiration. That is, in the absence of oxygen, glucose will be broken down to release carbon dioxide, alcohol, and energy. As yeast produces alcohol in the process of respiration, it is used for the preparation of wines and beers. The organisms like yeast which undergo anaerobic respiration are called anaerobes.